Hello, my dear students, my friends, and all online friends. Now I am back once again, and today I am going to teach you a new lesson. And the name of the new lesson is case. Now I hope everybody knows about the case, and the students of primary level, secondary level, and lower level also knows about the case. Case is the form of pronoun. Now everyone, look on the board. Today I am going to teach case. C-A-S-E, case. Case is the form of pronoun, and it is very important, and not only very important, it is the most important. It is the most important topic that you have to know, and that all students have to know about the case. Because without the definition and the knowledge of case, we cannot afford any English grammar, and you cannot be perfect in English grammar. So the students who need to be perfect in English grammar, please listen to me carefully and study carefully the case, and please be continue with our video, and please like, comment, and share. Now thank you, and please look on the board. Now here, English grammar. Today we will learn about case. Now everyone look on the board, please, carefully. Case. First of all, we have to know about the definition. First of all, we have to know about the definition of case. What is meant by case, and what do you mean by case? So try to be learned it. Now please, the forms, you can say easily, the forms of pronouns are known as case. Now everyone, please look on the board and look the definition. It is very simplest definitions in English grammar. The forms of pronouns are known as case. Pronouns को जो forms होते हैं, pronouns को जो रूप होते हैं, जिन दोस्त को अलग अलग बनावट, अलग अलग ढांचा होते हैं, that type of forms are known as the case. Case is the most simplest topic in our English grammar. But without the knowledge of case, we cannot afford any English grammar, and we cannot be perfect in English grammar. So before learning tenses, learning additions, voice, elements, concords, etc., etc., we have to be learned about the case. Now look on the board. Everybody look on the board, please. We continue with our video. The forms of pronouns are known as case. The forms of pronouns, pronouns ko roop, pronouns ko jun alag alag roop huncha, that type of forms are known as the case. And according to our English grammar, case is categorized in three different categories. Now please listen to me once again. I'm going to tell once again. According to our English grammar, tense is categorized in three different categories. And the three different categories are nominative case, that is also known as the subjective case. Nominative case is also known as the subjective case, and the another is possessive case. And possessive case have also two forms. And the last category is objective case. Objective case. There are three types of case. Now please look on the board. Everyone look on the board. Case is categorized in three different categories. Now everyone look on the board. Case is categorized in three different categories. According to the English grammar, among American English or British English, case is categorized in three different categories. One category is, now these are number one category is nominative case, and another category is possessive case. And another name is objective case. Case is categorized in three different categories. They are nominative case and possessive case and objective case. And nominative case is also known as subjective case. Subjective case. मैं इसे सिलेक्ट हुई. Now everyone look on the board. Case is categorized in three different categories. One category is nominative case, another category is possessive case, and another category is objective case. In that case, nominative case is also known as subjective case. Nominative case is also known as subjective case, and subjective case is also known as nominative case. Nominative case and subjective case are the similar name of each other. So today we learn about the nominative case, possessive case, and objective case. The nominative case plays the role of subject. Now look once again. Nominative case plays the role of subject. Possessive case shows the relations between objective case and nominative case. And the objective case is used as the object in the sentence. Now everyone look. We have to learn. First of all, we have to learn about the schedule of case and the forms of case. Now everyone look. Case schedule. Now everybody look on the board. It is case schedule. In this schedule, we will learn about the forms of cases. This means what type of case is what? What type of case belongs to what? That means what is the form of possessive? What is the form of objective? What is the form of nominative? We will learn about that in this case schedule. Case schedule, case talika. Now everyone look. I'm going to prepare a table and make a table. Now everyone look. This is the case schedule. This is the case schedule. Here it is nominative case. Nominative case. And another it is possessive case. And another is objective case. Before studying the past chapters of English grammar, we have to learn about the case and the case schedule and the forms of pronoun. And when we discuss about the forms of pronoun will be discussed as the case. Now, here are three types of case. They are nominative case, possessive case, and objective case. And nominative case has got two forms. So, please everybody look on the board. There are seven nominative cases. That means there are seven nominative pronouns or subjective pronouns. And the subjective and nominative pronouns are, now look everybody here, are I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. Finally, there are seven nominative pronouns in our English grammar. Now look everybody. Number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, and number 7. There are seven forms of, so there are seven nominative cases or subjective pronouns. They are I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. And the seven nominative forms will have to be learned because without the knowledge of case, grammar is impossible, both American English and British English. So please be careful about the case and get knowledge with me. I'm going to draw a table of each. This table belongs to I. We, you, he,
Sorry, sorry. A C Okay, I'm going to turn after we repeat, but now I can't. Now everyone look. Okay, please stop once again. So, sorry for the interruption. Nominative case is categorized in 7 categories. They are I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. And similarly, you can know about the possessive case and adjective case. We have to learn what is the possessive form of nominative cases and what is the possessive form of adjective case. Now, please look on the board. My and the mine are the forms of I. And I is nominative case, and my and mine are the possessive case of I. And similarly, we can learn about we. Our. Our is the possessive form of nominative we and ours. Ours is the possessive form of nominative case, that is we. So, we can say that our and ours are both, ours and ours are both, are the possessive forms of nominative case, me. And your and yours are the possessive forms of you and his alone. His is the possessive form of he. Her and hers are the possessive form of she, it and its are the possessive forms of it, and you can say their and theirs are the possessive forms of they. And similarly, you can say that me is the objective form of I, us is the objective form of we, you is the objective form of you, him is the objective form of him, her is the objective form of she, it is the objective form of it, and them is the objective form of they. Now, please look on the board once again. There are seven nominative pronouns. They are I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. And the possessive forms of I are my and mine. The possessive forms of we are our and ours. And the possessive forms of you are your and yours. And the possessive forms of he is his. And the possessive forms of she are her and hers. And the possessive forms of it are it and its. And the possessive forms of they are their and theirs. And now we have to learn about the objective case. So, the objective form of I, mine is me. The objective form of we, ours is us. The objective form of you, yours is you. The objective form of he, his is him. The objective form of she, hers is her. The objective form of it is it. And the objective form of theirs is them. So guys, everyone, look on the board carefully and listen to me carefully and be concentrate on your study about the case. Because this is the most important chapter and the topic or the lessons that you have to learn and that our students have to learn before making or before preparing the first follows of English grammar. And the students who needs to be perfect about the English grammar, he or she needs to be perfect about case or persons. Without the help of persons and without the help of case, the first follows of grammar is impossible. Like as that, voices, imperative sentences, or the different forms of sentences, agreement, verb concords, connectives, prepositions, and narration or speeches. Before making of them, we have to learn about case. Case is the most important chapter, and now you have a homework. So please be concentrated on our study. And visit for a half of hour in your home and study this chapter and study this table once, twice and thrice in a way. If you do that, you will learn case carefully and vastly. Please. And I request everybody and I request all of my students and all of my friends to copy the case schedule on your notebook or your copies and copy the case schedule on your notebook and please this chart, learn about the chart and be ready for the English grammar. Thank you everybody. Namaste.